from the University of South Carolina. Your news, your sports, your weather. Carolina News begins now.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Leland Williams, and this is the FastCast, where we tell you today's top stories in 5 minutes or less. The Fort Dallas officer who fatally shot a woman in her own home has been released on bond after being jailed for murder. After body cam footage was released, Aaron Dean resigned from the Fort Worth Police Department. He is still being charged with murder. A fight was broken up at a local high school that left one 18-year-old student getting tased. The school resource officer at Richland Northeast High School says they saw three students kicking another student on the ground while a large group ran away. Two of the students have been charged with disturbing the peace while the third got away. State election officials are testing out a new voting system. It will be paper-based and has already been tested out in Aiken County where voters were able to use it with little instruction. You make a selection on the touch screen, then you print the ballot out. You then take this printed ballot to a scanner, which reads the barcodes at the top of the paper, which then casts your vote. A boil water advisory is in place for everyone who lives near Trinum Road and Beltline Boulevard. Late last night, a water main burst and a sinkhole appeared. This is causing traffic jams, and everyone in the area is being asked to take a detour route while the hole is being fixed. A Columbia mother has been reunited with her child who was stolen out of her driveway from the back seat of her SUV. The baby was found near Old Congaree Run unharmed. People say they saw the child standing in the parking lot and immediately knew something was off. After calling the police, the child was reunited with his family. And so far, it's looking beautiful up here on the garden on top of the SJMC. Lauren Davis is in the studio right now to let you know how the weather's going to be looking. Lauren, how's the weather?
So it's going to get up to 78 degrees today, and we'll see some afternoon showers. Going into tomorrow, we'll also have some rain. But thankfully, we see some sun on Thursday, Friday, and Saturday before we see rain again on Sunday. So if you want to go to the fair, definitely go before then. And I'm also excited for some sun on Saturday because we're kicking off at noon against Florida. And I'm so happy that we beat Georgia in that upset. Next is sports with Zach Sweat. Zach, how about the game against Georgia last weekend?
Thanks, Lauren. The Gamecocks are raking in awards after Saturday's upset over the third-ranked Georgia Bulldogs in Athens. Head coach Will Muschamp was named the Dodd Trophy Coach of the Week after leading the Gamecocks to victory as heavy underdogs and snapping a four-game losing streak against their border rivals. Defensive back Israel Mukwamu earned SEC Defensive Player of the Week honors, as well as Walter Camp National Player of the Week honors after his three-interception performance on Saturday. Not to be outdone, defensive tackle Javon Kinlaw was awarded with SEC Defensive Lineman of the Week honors after he continued his dominance in the trenches with four tackles and a sack. South Carolina welcomes the ninth-ranked Florida Gators into Williams-Brice Stadium this Saturday. Kickoff for that game is set for noon. Now back to you, Leland.
Thank you, Zach. And to round out this FastCast, a little something to pull at your heartstrings. Every father dreams of walking their daughter down the aisle to meet her new husband, and one father finally got his wish fulfilled in the form of a new kidney. Reginald L. Jones had been waiting for 5 years for a new kidney, and when he got the call a week before his daughter's wedding, he and his daughter were so excited and thankful. Well, that's all the time that we have for today. I hope you really enjoyed this FastCast. My name is Leland Williams. Thank you again so much for tuning in. Until next time.